Hi guys, welcome to my workbench. Got something cool to show you. It's an Arduino Nano powered by a power bank and a whole bunch of resistors. That's all the parts. The output of the resistors is connected to one of the inputs of my oscilloscope. Let me show you what it does. You might be wondering, what's the big deal about Hello World? Well, if you give me a couple minutes, I think I can show you why this is so cool. As its name suggests, an oscilloscope is a device that allows you to see the oscillation or change in a signal. Say you have a blank sketch like this. It's really easy to see how the signal changes from low to high, low to high. In the oscilloscope, you could see the same oscillation. So when it's on, you could see it go high. When it's off, it's low. However, if the blink goes faster and faster, it becomes harder and harder to see on the LED. Like right now, the LED appears to be completely solid, but as you can see, it's actually still pulsed. If I zoomed in, you can see even though most of the time it's actually on, there is a small dip right here. That made me wonder if I could create just the right pattern of pulses to create text on the screen. Let's say we want to draw a letter A, for instance. On an inkjet printer, they have a row of these little nozzles. So all these nozzles are in one printhead that move together at the same time. As it moves across the paper, certain nozzles would squirt the ink and certain ones would not. The process continues, leaving just the right dots on the paper as the nozzle moves across. So I thought I could duplicate the same thing using the oscilloscope. But to do that, I'm gonna need a ton of channels. So that's where the resistors come in. They convert the digital output of the Arduino into an analog signal. When all these pins are zero, that will also become zero because the scope is not getting any positive from anywhere. And when all these becomes positive, we'll have the maximum voltage here. And in between, we have a gradual change from zero through 5 volts. So this is the code that draws the sawtooth you see on the screen. Setup is just one line using the direct port manipulation to set up all port D bits to output. And loop is pretty simple. We're just looping through the variable y from 0 to 255. For every value of y, we slam the bits to port D, which corresponds to Arduino pin D0 through D7, which we have the resistors on. The delay is such that we hold each value for 50 microseconds to leave a visible trail on the scope. By putting an if statement, we can choose which y we are going to plot. In this case, it will only plot when the y is divisible by 25. As you can see, by changing the value of y, we are changing the voltage, and therefore we are changing the vertical position of the beam on the screen. The problem is we can only have one value at any one time, because we only have one channel. So as we change the value, time has passed, so we cannot put two lines on top of each other. We really need to be able to do that to draw vertical lines. Thankfully, oscilloscopes are pretty flexible, and you could adjust the horizontal time division. You could think of it as zooming out and therefore seeing less resolution, and at this lower resolution, we can no longer see the time that it took for us to make that vertical change. So now that we could display a grid, displaying a character is just a matter of sending the right bytes as the beam moves across the screen. Since we have 255 levels to play with vertically, we have plenty of vertical space to display more than one line of text. And by adjusting the vertical and horizontal scale on the scope, we can expand or contract both vertically and horizontally. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this little diversion. This is not what an oscilloscope is designed to do, but I sure had fun making it do this. If you enjoyed this, don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and all that. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.